Good afternoon, Program Director and colleagues. Over the last number of years, it has become quite clear that an urgent paradigm shift is required from a reactive way of managing health and safety to a proactive behavioral-based culture and attitude within the mining South African industry. Let me start off with one of the fundamental principles of health and safety, and that is everyone's business. I would even go further to say that prevention should be a way of living and a culture amongst all of us in the workplace. This event here today should not be deemed as merely another talk show or as window dressing, but should present proof that all involved do indeed regard health and safety as everyone's business. What we experience today involves a major paradigm shift from reactive health and safety strategies and attitudes towards a behavioral-based proactive culture amongst management and employees in the mining industry. Critically important, health and safety strategies emphasized here today, such as reporting unsafe working practices and to stop unsafe working practices without the fear of victimization, forms the basis for cultivating a sustainable risk management culture throughout the industry, empowering people to respond to activities appropriately and to enable them to predict, prevent, and control unsafe incidents and accidents. Continuous risk management is indeed an innovative approach in managing the health of our workforce. It further entails a shared visible process aimed at eliminating a risk behavior, creating a sustainable non-discriminatory practice. Some of our other very important key objectives involved in health and safety should be creating risk competence within the entire workforce, installing visible felt leadership as a value, recognizing and rewarding safety behavior and persons being proactive. Behavior-based safety is obvious, the next logical step in the process of continuous improvement and is an essential prerequisite for world-class performance. Health and safety should not only be about the reduction of incidents, injuries, and fatalities, but about the total elimination through proactive, non-risk-based behavior. It is also about the ability of management to influence and control the behavior of people. It is furthermore important to remember that health and safety can only be attained through teamwork, healthy employer-employee relations in the workplace, total commitment, and most importantly, by changing the behavior of people to benefit themselves. It is essential because the finest health and safety campaign systems and equipment cannot function effectively if not correctly applied and monitored. And the most vigilant strategies will fail if not supported by aligned health and safety behavior and attitudes. Ladies and gentlemen, mining-related deaths have orphaned too many children, widowed too many women, and devastated too many families. And that is why we need many more initiatives such as this day within our industry. I want to close by quoting some words from our previous president, Mr. Nelson Mandela. He said, "My country is rich in minerals and gems that lays beneath its soils, but I always known that its greatest wealth is its people, finer and truer than the finest diamonds." You also wish to challenge all role players to stop sending out negative, distorted messages into the media and rather pledged its members' total commitment towards health and safety and towards the total elimination of discriminatory practices within the South African mining industry into the future. Under the current economic constraints, we owe it to South Africa and its Rainbow Nation to create a culture of tolerance and behavior-based safety, especially whilst managing the third wave we are currently experiencing. Thank you very much.